And now it's time to put little to and tune only radio show that helps you.
This place is or was paradise. So Marcus, the now deep-voiced butler, drives you all down to the community center.
Not Ernest.
Ernest on a bus.
Okay. Says, on top where did Ernest go?
I saw him hitch a ride on a bus.
Okay.
Don't worry about him. Meet up with him.
Why are you guys going to the community center anyway?
You know, that's above your pay grade for now.
You betcha, boss. Don't even sweat it. We'll just forget this conversation ever happening. Like, winks at you five times.
Marcus, you're a little weird, but you're pretty great.
Hey, thanks, boss. He winks eight more times.
All right.
Please. Sorry, it's a twitch.
Well, now I feel bad.
Ernest gets to the community center first, and then the rest of you pull up, and he says, "This is your stop."
I scream when I hear my Marcus's voice.
Uncle Fundy.
He hit puberty.
Boy. What happened to your voice? What did your mama tell you?
Nothing. She died at a very young age.
Well, I'm sorry about that. That sucks. But she should have told you before she died to not hit puberty, because that shit sounds weird.
I don't think it's reversible, Uncle Fundy.
I'm sure you could pay someone.
Yeah, we could go to the Home Depot.
Can I punch you in the throat and see?
Please don't, Uncle Fundy.
All right, I'm going to grab Ernest by the arm and try and pull him inside. I'm like, hey, bud, let's go.
That's not my boy.
Marcus, a tear rolls down his
cheek. I put my hand on Marcus's shoulder and I just, don't worry, he'll come around.
Thanks, boss. You have fun in there. Be safe.
Oh, okay.
Did we bring a radio?
We're hoping to find one inside.
I meant to bring one. My bad.
I think at some point we should stop at a store and buy a radio so that we can always have one with us.
Portable radios were definitely not invented at the time. Hey, Marcus, before you leave.
Yeah.
Can you go buy a radio?
You have a bunch of radios.
Okay, go grab one of the radios from the house and bring it here.
Oh. We need our jams. Community jams.
Okay, it might be a little while.
That's okay.
It's fine. We'll be here a while.
Okay,
we're
bye.
We're gonna search for more jams. Okay, let's go search for some jams.
Yay, jams! That's what we need. See you, Marcus.
He's driving away.
Good.
All right. Well, we're here.
Okay.
I'm gonna walk inside.
You do that. You're standing in a rather quiet lobby. You can see a reception area through some glass windows. The door looks like it's just a little ways away from you.
Is there someone at the reception desk?
Yeah.
I elbow Ernest and I go, I got this one. And I slide up in there.
All right. It's a...
As you pass me, I pat you on the back. I'm like, you got this.
It's an older gentleman.
I look at him and I'm like, just your tab.
He's thinning just a little bit on the top.
Gerald's dad.
He's got a thick walrus mustache. He says, hey, can I help you today, buddy?
Well.
Ask me what this accent is. It just sort of came out.
Kind of sounds like South Dakota.
Hey.
Well, South that Dakota, is where I'm from. Oh, God, it's morphing. Quickly, tell me what you need before I go full Kermit the Frog. Heidi who? What's the haps, paps? What can I do for you? Good lord.
I cannot with that accent.
Welcome to the Sensible Community Center. What can I do for you?
Well, you know, I had a friend who worked here a short while ago.
What's the name?
Isaacs.
Oh. Well, I am sorry if you came here to see him. Because
Isaac with Miss Piggy. Should I go find Miss Piggy? Is she in the back?
Isaacs has not been with us for about 2 months.
Oh, wow. Well, this is awkward.
Is there something I can help you with instead?
No, Kermit.
No, my name's not Kermit.
What is your name?
My name is Harbor.
Harbor Johnson.
No, not Johnson. Harbor
Johnston.
Johnston. That's it. Harbor Johnston.
I'm gonna call you Kermit.
I'm gonna call you Carbo.
I'm gonna call you Kerm.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to be rude. I have several calls waiting. Is there something I can help you with?
I'm sorry, how busy is a community center that you have several calls waiting?
Pretty busy. A local celebrity is holding an art class here in a few hours, and people are trying to get last-minute tickets.
What's their name? Are they
What's
hot?
Their name?
Their name is...
Anderson...
The famous artist...
They're actually the artist formerly known as... Boop.
It's
So I slide up next to next to my buddy Jimmy James here.
Heidi Who?
Listen,
That's her name. Heidi Who?
Listen, buddy, I am also a local celebrity, and my name is Ernest. Maybe you've heard of me, Mr. Fundamental Misunderstanding Hawthorne.
Might know better as Durnest.
Are you Durnest. The cultist?
No, I'm not.
He, like, pulls out the phone. He's like, is there a warrant for your arrest? I need money.
You are a fucking freak. Put the phone down, Kermit.
Don't you threaten me. I'm a civil servant.
I raise my hand as if to threaten. I'm going to smack him.
Me?
No, not you.
Okay.
Kerm.
Whoa. We can't hit Kermit here.
I don't actually want to, but I am going to make it.
No, Miss Piggy will fuck us up,
dude. We should call him a Herb, because it's kind of like Kerm.
All right, roll intimidation.
Well, I guess he's not going to be your boyfriend now.
It's like 91.
You put your hand down this instant.
I'm going to walk over very casually.
I put my hand down very quickly.
I'm going to walk over now and be like, hello, sir.
Are you with these lunatics?
Why
do we always do this?
No, I'm sorry. I'm just trying to find,
I understand what's going on. I pull Ernest, and I'm just like, we gotta get out of here.
No, I'm sorry. I'm actually just trying to find, the room where, that artist. I'm sorry. I always forget her name.
Sorry, guys. I farted.
Oh, well, they're gonna be in room 305.
Okay, thanks so much, sir.
Okay.
Have a lovely day.
I will do my very best. A little frazzled now.
Bye-bye, Kermit.
A lot of shit just happened.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Are we going with her?
Can I make, I don't know. Can I make a check to make
Should
my friend
Should we sneak
now?
In the window so that way Kermit doesn't know we're with
make
her?
Make a friend check.
Good call. Let's...
Make an appearance check.
I go
check.
Outside.
Okay. Well, that passed. I got a 69.
Nice. He looks a little more reassured by you.
All right, well, have a great day.
You betcha. All
right.
I guess.
I walked through the door, and I'm kind of motioning for the two to fucking follow me.
No, we've gone
fucking
outside.
Muppet-looking freak. I don't say that to him.
Wait, no, are you guys outside now?
Yeah, we went outside.
We're going to break into the window.
Oh, my God. No, I'm going to look. I'm going to poke my head outside and be like, gosh, come on. Come on, don't do this.
I stealth inside.
Oh, goddamn. I walk inside.
Okay, you're back inside. You're all inside. Again, Kermit doesn't see you. He's facing away from the door.
His big old Muppet eyes can't see us.
Okay, come on, let's go find a room with a radio, or at the very least, check out 305, see what's happening there.
Let's check out 305, because maybe it has a radio.
Okay.
You go to room 305, there's a huge line outside the door, and a frazzled-looking community center employee is like, hi, do you guys have tickets?
To your heart. I rolled to become his friend.
Okay.
I liked your little singing.
I got a 4!
That's the nicest and most romantic thing anyone's ever said to me. Do you guys, seriously though, do you have tickets? I got a line.
Of course I do. And I turn around and draw 3 tickets.
What?
Wait, no. He's a photographer. He's the one here to take photos.
Oh, yeah, press. I'm press. I'm part of it. I draw a little press badge.
No. Don't draw any press badge. Pull out your camera.
I really want to use this
I pull out my camera, too. We're press.
Press.
We've been hired to photography.
Oh, I didn't get any notices. About
nope, here it is. Here's the memo. I pull out a piece of paper and put it away.
Listen,
I walk up and I shake his hand. I'm like, oh, great meeting with you. Let's go, everyone.
listen, I'm laughing here. I'm having a real good time. You guys are a real riot. No, seriously though, I'm actually not paid enough to deal with this. If there's
exactly.
something,
so just let us in.
If there's something I can help you with, I'm more than happy to.
I'm fine. I pull him aside and I say, listen, we're press, but apparently that's not a thing here.
You're press?
Of course we're press.
We're pressing.
We are
get
the
it.
Press.
And you're here for this local artist seminar?
We're not big press. I never said that we're the
yeah,
sins
we
of our times.
So you're not here to investigate the missing, janitorial staff, like all those other people who rolled up here and said they were...
Well, now I feel like this guy's being an asshole to us.
Yes, sir, we never said we were...
I look at him dead in the eyes and I say, I'm just going to give you some money so you can let us in, but you know what? Go fuck yourself.
Hey, go fuck yourself.
I pull Jimmy James away. Wow! Woo!
Wow!
I turned to Ernest and I said, I'm really on my game today.
Yeah, that guy was a fucking asshole.
All right. Well, now what do? We fucked up. Well,
I turn invisible.
I cast magic missile.
Oh, God.
His head explodes.
I run inside.
All right, so...
That's the side adventure in a different universe.
Do we... Oh, God, how...
Let's go into another room. Let's see if maybe
yeah,
we can break
fuck
through the
this
wall.
Guy, and I flipped him off as we walk away.
Okay.
I shake his hand.
Yeah, as I walk away, I'm literally... My hands to my eyes, so I don't have to look at this man as I try and scoot away quickly.
You feel his cold eyes follow you the whole way down the hallway.
I didn't do anything to this poor man.
So you guys just gonna duck into, like, a random room?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
The room right next to 305. So 306.
304. You're in 304. It's actually right across the hall.
So this guy watched us just walk into another room?
Yeah. You are now in an empty community center room. The lights are off since
it's
not
in
use. There's not a radio. Can you guys make spot hidden checks for me?
I did it! I got a regular success.
I got 10.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's a success.
Jimmy James, your eyes are immediately drawn to a piece of paper taped to the wall that appears to have a listing of all the rooms and what their jobs are.
I grab it, and I look.
Idiot.
Check if there's a radio room. I look for a radio room.
You don't see a radio room, but you do pick out that... The office belonging to Isaacs was 207.
Guys, Isaacs was in 207. Let's hit it up.
Okay. I skadoodle on out of there.
Okay. You feel, again, those cold eyes.
As we're walking by whatever that dude's name was,
you never
I asked. Give him the dirtiest look I can.
And then I look at him, I say, hey, what's your name?
If looks could kill you guys, like...
As I walk by, I give him the most apologetic look I possibly can in the hopes that this man doesn't hate me as the rest of the world seems to.
This guy is getting such mixed signals.
Yeah.
Can I roll for, like, empathy or something?
Another appearance check, I guess?
You really just don't like it when people don't like
I don't!
You. We're probably never going to see this guy again.
Probably not, but I failed it.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like he hates you even more now.
Oh, no!
Yeah, it looks like he interpreted your sympathetic look as like a, oh, a little baby gonna cry!
I say, oh, a little baby gonna cry!
a tear rolls down my
cheek. And then I fart in his direction.
So are you guys going to make your way down to 207?
Yeah.
Okay, you do that. The door is locked. On the actual door, it is written in Isaac's. Okay, no, you hang on. Just give me one second. On it is written Isaac's, and then a dash and janitorial staff.
Can I punch it now?
There is a odor pouring out from under the door.
What is the odor?
Ernest, is that you?
I did that upstairs. Thank you.
It very distinctly. Smells like the sea, like the ocean.
I pull out my whip.
Stop, Bobo! We found it!
Stop, Bobo!
You don't hear anything.
Alright.
I knock.
There's no answer.
Can I try to pick the lock?
Is lockpicking a skill?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's check if the door is unlocked first.
No, I said it was locked.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. I think I have like a 25 unlock.
I punched a lock.
Beth.
Okay, well, let's have Ernest try and lockpick first.
Oh, I fail.
Okay, yeah, you don't lockpick. Your pick breaks.
Immediately.
What is it, Skyrim?
More like Fallout.
Hey, I got a hard success.
All right, you punch through the glass in the door.
I smirk at the both of you. I'm like, ha ha. And then I hold my injured arm.
Yeah, and then your hand is bleeding everywhere, you fucking stupid.
Wipe it on the door.
With your hard success, like, you're actually really fine. Oh. I mean, like, you did punch through the glass, so it's probably like blood, but you don't take any damage, is what I'm saying.
My knuckles are used to this brutality.
The room inside, it's a decent sized sort of storage space. There's a chair, there's a radio. What's unusual is everything is soaking wet and dripping.
And Sababo!
Nothing.
Oh, we have to turn it to 13.4. Sorry.
All right, you do that.
No, I'm not even in the room. My hand's just sticking through the door. Well, I'm gonna unlock it.
Okay, let's unlock the door and open it. And as you
lock it behind us.
As you proceed further in, I mean, it is broken.
No.
You can see that not only is everything soaking wet, it looks like there's like seaweed hanging off.
I stuffed some in my purse.
This guy was a mermaid.
Wait, I have seaweed now, guys. I'm gonna write that down. I'm gonna go home and make some snacks. How much do I have?
All the seaweed. You have, what do you want me to tell you, like, ounces? What do you want
five
from me?
Yeah, I want ounces.
Okay, we'll say you have 8 ounces of seaweed.
Dude, that's a lot of weed.
Ooh. It's
seaweed, not when it's though. Sea, though.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it sort of devalues it a lot. The high isn't really as strong. That's stupid.
Wow.
You're all in the room. It reeks of the ocean and everything's wet.
Wow. I turned the radio at 13.4.
Okay. Is there a radio in the room?
Yeah, it said there was a radio.
So, Babo, we found it.
Yeah, you did. What's it look like out there?
It's really fucking wet in here.
That's weird.
It's like oceany.
Hey, listen. So, I'm getting really, really strong signals on this end. Gonna be able to send you through no problem. The issue is, I don't know where you're going, and I don't know if I can get you back so easily.
That's a problem.
Well, this looks like ocean world, so can all of us swim? I can. Can you guys?
I feel like one of us, I can. I feel like you can't. I feel like that was a thing.
I think I said that in the previous episode that I can't swim.
Yeah. I think you did. Okay. All right, well, don't go swimming then. Problem solved.
Okay, but what if this transports us into, like, the middle of an ocean world?
I don't know. Two of you can swim. Grab them by an arm and hoist them up.
That's not easy. Have you ever tried to swim?
I'm a fucking demon owl. Exactly. All right, there's not a lot of water down here.
Exactly. So you don't know how hot it is.
I guess that's fair. Well, give him pointers, I guess. Do you want me to send you over?
I guess.
Is there anything in the office that looks like it'll float?
Yeah, it looks like there's like a sturdy plank of wood that you.
All right,
could...
I pick it up and give it to Ernest, and I'm like, worst comes to worst, you hold on to this bad boy.
Oh, use it as a weapon.
No.
If you're in the water, just move your legs and hold on to this.
Kick your legs. Don't just move them in any direction.
Yeah.
No water dancing.
Move them in a circular pattern.
Okay.
I'm going to transport you now.
We're all good, so Bob.
All right. Listen, good luck. Break a leg out there. I'm sure I'll talk to you soon.
No, we need our legs to swim.
I pull out my revolver.
James, no!
Ernest in the leg.
Oh, no.
And as you're swinging it down, everything goes black.
Oh, I fucked up, guys.
Oh, no. It's just like New Year's.
Can you guys make constitution throws for me, please?
Yeah, that's an extreme success.
That is a success.
Also a success.
So, none of you can tell how much time has passed. Ernest, you open your eyes first.
Yeah, I do.
You are lying on a wooden floor in a dark room.
Do we still have my piece of wood?
your piece of wood is lying a few feet away from you.
I can grab it.
Well, hang on. Hold on. In the distance through a nearby window, you can hear the sound of lapping waves. And then you smell something, Ernest.
Is it fishy?
It is extremely fishy.
Oh, boy.
It's a mermo.
It's a mermaid.
And as you look up, there is a horrifying creature standing over you.
It's that guy from the Shape of Water.
Have I moved by this point? Like,
no. Like literally, you've opened your eyes, and these are the first things you've been able to see.
All right, I'm going to stay very still.
So this creature has the upper body and the torso of a fish. But whatever happened to it, it doesn't look like it was perfect. It still has these patches of like pale skin here and there. And the bottom half, it's bipedal. And it appears to be dressed in almost like a ragged cloth. And it blinks and it notices you staring at it. And
I close my eyes.
you feel it get closer and closer, and then you hear a voice bark. And as it barks,
it doesn't literally bark.
Okay.
I need to be clear on that.
As you hear it shout, Dandy and Jimmy James, you are also shook back into consciousness. And the voice says, "Desist! Get out! Leave!" And Ernest, you feel it get closer and closer to you. Not the voice, the fish. And you hear, "Ah, shit! You guys up?"
Yes?
Hold on. Is my magnum gun still in my hand?
How close are we to Ernest?
Yeah, I thought you said you had your rifle.
No, I pulled out the gun. I called it revolver.
Okay. You can see it lying a few feet away from you.
Okay.
How close are we to Ernest?
He is probably about 8 feet from you, Dandy, and probably about 12 feet from you, Jimmy James.
Do we see this fish thing?
Oh yeah.
I sit up and pull out my knife.
I lunge for the piece of wood.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Seeing this, I lunge for my gun.
You all arm yourselves and. The fish makes a horrifying guttural noise. And you hear, "Ah, shit, let him have it." And it's time for some combat.
Stab him in the leg.
Okay, that's not how combat works.
Stupid human looking leg.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how good is that leg?
Like, does it have some nice calf muscles?
Yeah.
Sexy? It's partially scaly.
Oh.
That doesn't matter.
Is it hairy, kind of?
It's a little hairy. Ooh. Part of it just looks...
Hairy and scaly. Those are, like, the worst.
It also looks a little bulbous and deformed.
Because of being so, in the like, water
so
much.
So, like, a 2?
Like
probably a 2 out of 10. Dandy, you're first.
Great. I'm going to stab him in the leg.
Okay, you run up. Do you scream or say anything?
Yeah.
Okay, and you are going to attempt to stab it in the leg. It's going to try and actually dodge out of the way of that.
I got a hard success.
Okay, it also got a hard success. That's attacker's choice, and you stab it.
What did I roll?
A 3.
6.
Okay. Yeah, you stab it in the leg for 6 damage, and a awful green liquid spurts out of it.
Ew!
Jimmy James, you're next.
Remembering that I suck with my pistol, I swapped my rifle real quick.
Okay, yeah. You hold your pistol in your hand, and you're like, "Eh," and you pull out your rifle.
And then it's just the fishy guy, right?
Yeah.
Now. Okay. I aim for his head. That is a hard success.
Okay. It once again matches as it lunges for you, Jimmy James, seeing that you're, you know, going to do something. But you get the shot off, and you get it. Go ahead and roll.
That is a 16.
Oh, shit. This thing is dead. This thing is like stripped.
Yeah, you literally blast it and it goes flying back, crashes into a bookshelf on the far end of the room, and goes limp.
Do I hit him in the head?
No, you hit him in the chest.
Oh. Alright, there's your murder. There's your murder.
Hey, is it dead?
It's half a human. Yeah, it's a half murder.
I want to actively look around for the source of that voice.
It looks like it's coming from a speaker.
Oh.
Hello?
Hey! Who?
Who are you?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm Isaacs.
Guys, we found him!
Found me?
Wait, hold, Isaacs, I have a question.
I have one too. Who are all of you?
First, mine's more important.
No, I said who I was. All right, people don't just stumble into here.
Yeah, you see, the thing is...
We're on a secret mission.
What's your mission?
That's the best way to...
Also, no, names first. Names first, mission after.
I'm Ernest.
I'm Dandy.
And I'm Jimmy James. I know it sounds like a fake name, I swear it's not.
Okay.
Mine's actually a fake name. My name's really Durnest.
He's doing his Durnest.
Okay.
Now my question.
All right. Jimmy James is it?
Yes.
Now what's up?
Actually, I have like 20, but I guess I'll start with one. Did we just murder a human?
Well, kinda.
Was there any way to save him?
No. Cool. If he stopped listening to me, he's gone.
All right.
And that was one of the last ones, so if you see any more of those bastards, give him an old 1-2 for me.
Wait, can you control fish? You can...
Wait, hold on.
Are you a physical form or are you a radio now?
What?
Are you Aquaman?
No. No, I'm talking to you from somewhere else.
Is this like another dimension somewhere else? Do you need help out?
Help out of here?
Yeah, help getting out.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, cool. We're here to save you.
I'm gonna bang on the radio. Yo, Soul Bob, can you get us out of here?
Soul Bob.
There's no radio.
You just banged on the table.
Fuck off.
Where's the radio?
Hey, do you happen to know of any radios? That's a weird laugh. I don't like that laugh.
Don't do that anymore, Isaacs. I don't like that.
It's been a few weeks since I've seen a radio.
Well, I guess we're all trapped here now. We're all best friends now. Once again, I'm Dandy, and I fuck, man, I was gonna have a date with the Weezer.
Wait.
Fuck.
You guys came here to save me.
Kind of, but not really.
But kind of.
The only way to do that is through a radio.
Well, you see, that's our
way
back.
The only
way
out.
Yeah, a radio and mostly this room. We have to find a radio and bring it probably to this room.
Well, hope you like seafood.
I don't.
I do not.
I haven't had it in years because it's... Actually, I love it because it's Australian. There we go. That's exactly what he says, too.
Yeah, you hear through the speaker the shuffle of papers and say... He says...
Shuffle.
There's a bookshelf over in the corner. I left you a little something-something as a welcome gift.
I look at it immediately. I rush over.
Okay, there's a dead fish in the way.
Oh, I don't...
I loot the dead fish.
Okay, it doesn't have anything on it.
I pull out my knife and I'm like, I got this, guys.
Okay, I'm gonna step over the dead fish to go look at the bookshelf.
Are you gonna make yourself a cape, too?
I'm gonna try.
Is someone over there? I don't have any eyes in there.
I'm at the bookshelf.
All right, you're looking for a piece of paper. Just a normal-looking piece of paper.
It's going to be a piece of paper, and it just says, fuck you guys.
Yeah.
Owie.
Just so you guys know, I just failed
I
my
I can no longer put my
check.
Earring inside my ear.
You do find it.
Hey, whoa. I found it. Sunny, beautiful Ville de Lumiere.
Yeah, welcome to the Ville.
Are we in Weird?
What? Yeah, sorry. I don't have the exact same copy I sort of wrote on that one.
What's a fog?
Oh God! There's a lot of questions.
Can I see this?
No.
What are you guys looking at?
There's a boat.
As I'm trying to skin.
Oh wait,
the
is there
fish.
A radio on the boat? Have you ever been to the boat?
My God! You ask a lot of questions.
I am a private investigator.
Oh great!
I'd like to privately investigate that boat.
Yeah.
For radios.
You should use that as a pickup line. I'm a private investigator. I'd like to privately investigate that butt.
I'm gonna high five Jimmy James's gross fishy hand, and I'm just like, I'm absolute. If I ever get out of here and see Louise again, I'm absolutely using that on her.
So Jimmy James, make a survival check to skin the fish.
Oh, I did. I totally failed.
Okay, it's a mess. You have like a handful of scales.
Just like what I did with the lizard, I'm gonna put those in my pocket.
So, just you guys came here right through a radio.
Yes.
Are you familiar at all with this place?
The
by any chance?
Dimensions and the demons?
Oh my God, I guess you do know a little bit, huh?
Yeah, this isn't our first time doing this. This is, however, our first time without this is the second time doing this, and we had a radio the first time, so we had a little bit more help, but now we gotta find one.
Right.
The white is the fuck. Let me see.
Oh shit, that's Max.
What?
The white is the fog.
White. Oh no, that's not what I meant.
It's, well, really, it's just like I only have this much of a map to give you guys.
But it's, yeah, great.
Nothing.
I'm also I'll make sure a picture of this gets on the Twitter so that people can look at it. In the center of the map appears to be a large house that's been circled several times. There's another building up in the north end of the map that's been circled, and a circle with an X in a house not too far from the big one. To the back of the large house is some sort of rectangular square. I mean, squares in like a place where people gather, not...
Oh, I was like, okay, Max. It's a rectangle.
And written on it is weird.
It's actually Ernest's home.
Out to the east is a beach, followed by what appears to be an ocean or some sort of body of water. Sitting in the middle of it is a large white boat with a red X drawn on it. Also, there's one road leading to the north and the south. Both exits have been crossed with an X, and the word fog is written with an arrow pointing north and south. And that's the important things from the map, if you really don't want to go on the Twitter and find it.
I don't blame you.
Okay, Isaacs?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're the host of this place, I assume.
No, you betcha. Okay. Made a deal with the devil. Sorry,
wait.
Listen.
No, you betcha. Listen. That's an answer.
You gotta leave and not... I know we have no way out, but we have to leave and, like, not continue associating with the demons and stuff.
I got a question real quick. Why? Why?
Why what?
Why do you want to be a demon man?
Why'd I want my own reality?
That you can no longer escape from?
It wasn't like that at first.
But then you fucking ate
all the radios.
You made a deal with a demon.
I did do it.
I pulled Danny aside and said we did the same thing.
Yeah, he made a deal with us so we could stop people from doing this.
Okay.
Listen. If you were
not gonna get into the morality of all
if
that.
If you were in a bad place in your life and someone came to you, said they could give you a fresh start, would you do it?
I literally did that.
I do that every day.
This place is, or was, rather a paradise.
What happo?
What happo is about a month ago, this awful fog rolled in. Now, I had some friends, family, who came here with me. And they were all...
Members of the community center?
Yeah, they were all members. And they were inflicted.
Guys, we did it. We solved the mystery.
Yeah, so let's get out of here.
Sorry.
They were inflicted with this plague, this disease. I was unaffected, but they started to turn into these sort of awful sea animals.
Why were you unaffected?
Probably because I'm the host.
And...
Whoa, twinsies!
And who was that we just killed? Was that one of your friends?
Yeah, that was a good friend of mine. One of the last ones that listened to me too. I don't know a lot about this place, but
you have a wife?
Nope, unmarried. Wait, that's a weird silence that I don't like.
Wait! Did you ask him if he had a wife, and then he said no, he's married?
He's unmarried.
Unmarried. He says, but. They started to turn on me about 2 weeks ago, and that was again the last one. I had him drag you up here, get you out of the water.
Oh thanks.
One of us can't swim.
Well,
I won't tell you which one because just in case that comes in handy.
Ernest is drowning in a bucket of water in the background.
So anyway, moving right along.
I'm just imagining Ernest like bent over. And put his face in water and then panicked. And rather than pulling his face out,
just like wiggling around.
Bent over with his head in the bucket. As where Danny and I was just having a
conversation. I was imagining him doing a handstand in a bucket so his legs are just flailing.
Okay, Max, continue.
Once all the fog shit started happening and my, again, friends and family turned into awful sea monsters, I knew I had to get the fuck out of here.
So wait, you're not here?
So
I'm here, all right.
Okay, listen. Question: How did you talk to your demon at first?
Oh, radio contact, of course.
And
maybe we should destroy all radios.
They're already destroyed, bud.
Who destroyed them?
He did.
Who's
the demon?
Using pronouns, not
the demon. Listen,
what's the demon's name?
I'm not. Fuck. Hang on.
Barbalabob.
Bartholomew.
Barbalabob.
Barbaros.
Barbarossa.
I like that.
Just Barbaros.
His name is a pirate man.
Anyway, I wasn't leaving, and I'm still not leaving until I get what I want from this place.
Which is
the treasure on the ship.
Why don't you just swim out there?
Ship is completely sealed tight.
Do you try punching it?
No, I...
Well, there you go!
I did one better. And I tried to hire a team. I got a few people together when I knew I needed to get out of here. We were going to break into the ship, take all of its valuables, and then radio the hell out.
What is in the ship?
I don't know for certain.
Okay, well, this sounds like a dumb plan.
Is there definitely a radio in there?
All the radios are destroyed.
Well, we can't contact our demon to get the fuck out of here then.
Yeah, no.
Do
and
you
again,
have a radio?
No.
Well, no, he'd be
contacted. Also, what are you talking to us through? A speaker?
Yeah.
Yep.
Do you think that's close enough to a radio?
It's not.
Can we turn... is there anything that we can turn to 13.4?
Guys, I think that if there was anything, he would have done it already.
No. Not necessarily a radio. It could be... What if we drew a picture of a radio and put it at 13.4? Because, listen, fake radios... don't fucking work. But they work as a communication standpoint. So literally, what do we even have to lose if we take some wood and like...
Well, then let's do it. Stop talking about it and just do it.
Okay, yeah. I'm going to look around for some sort of box.
Okay.
I grab his wood.
As
Ernest just goes, whoa.
I look at him and I just like tear the wood out of his hands.
Okay, I went for a box.
Well, no. So as Dandy... scavenges around the room to get various arts and crafts supplies. Isaac's continues.
Wait, hold on. Did I steal the plank of wood from Ernest?
Yeah, you have the plank of wood now.
Okay, well,
he says,
I want to draw this thing.
Okay, yeah, you're all drawing while he's talking.
I'm just staring at the speaker. I'm not doing.
They're drawing. I'm gonna try an actual build, like a 3D model.
Okay, great. You're all right. Jimmy, James, and Dandy are doing arts and crafts as he continues. And he says, so I put together a team. We were going to break into the ship, steal the supplies, and get out. Had an explosions expert, had a police detective, and had a very charismatic young man.
It sounds like us.
I'm except, a PI.
Yeah.
Except I'm
charismatic.
Not attractive.
Charismatic. Or... detective. Murder.
Sounds about right to me.
All
right.
All right.
We're your new team, boyo.
We had the whole thing planned and set. And then the radios exploded.
Spontaneously just went boom, boom?
All at once.
It was How do you know they all did it at once?
All right, I guess the one that was near us exploded and all the others were broken within a short proximity.
That sucks, bro.
It does. What's worse is... My special charismatic friend died.
Oh no!
During that.
Oh, looks like I'll be the first to go.
The other two took off into the city. I haven't seen them in 2 weeks now.
Oh. So they could possibly still be alive?
No, they're probably fish.
Well, yeah, but they could...
Well, we don't know how that disease transmits.
The fog.
The fog.
The fog outside of town. Like I said, it rolled in and that's what did it. Okay. It's what keeps us here.
So we can't leave this square. Are we safe in this like plot of land?
Oh yeah, as long as the fog doesn't roll back in.
If it does roll back in, is there
where hide? Are you where you're safe?
Well, it doesn't matter. He's the host. He could wander around in Fog Town and probably be safe.
Yeah, almost definitely. Don't really want to. Feels icky, but I could.
Okay.
Does it smell like fish?
It does.
Nice. So for us, is there any place that is sealed up enough that if the fog does roll in again, we won't be turned into fish people?
This place is pretty safe, but I don't mean to be rude. I don't know any of you. You all just sort of came here.
Yeah, I know.
Claiming to be saviors, but don't really seem we to be getting really, me out.
Oh, I guess we did claim to be saviors.
Well, I mean, think about it this way. Before we got here, you definitely didn't have a way out. Now, you have a chance. So, I don't know.
Also, realize we're the only person you can talk to right now.
Yeah.
Well, I guess that's fair. It has been a few days without any real human contact.
Yeah, we can hug.
Nope.
Nope.
Oh, okay.
So, anyway.
3 hours later.
That's where we're at now.
Oh, that's great.
Welcome to the villa. Probably not going to talk to you again for a little while. And unless you have something else to say, I'll just get going.
Where are you going?
Away.
Can you hear us at all times? Like, if we need to talk to you?
Meh.
Okay, well, we'll just hope that you can hear us when we need to contact you.
I can't imagine why you would.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thanks for the help, Buck.
Buck? Did you just make up a name for this man? Alright, Buck it is.
And now the three of you are alone with a smelly fish corpse and a map.
I kick it again. Not the map.
Alright, so here's...
I finished my drawing of...
I finished my little stupid radio thing.
Wow, okay. It took me as long to draw a radio as it did for her to make a 3D.
Yeah, but Jimmy James, your radio looks really good.
Yeah, like, I actually think it's a real radio.
Hey everybody, Mark here for your regularly scheduled ad break. Thank you guys so much for listening. Seriously, thank you so much. Right now, you're listening to the first episode of our second arc. The arc is titled The Misery of Fortune. Pretty cool name. The next episode will be coming out February 5th, next Monday. We don't have anything super special, like a one-off or anything, coming up within the next few weeks, but we do have some pretty cool plans in the works right now. We think it's really cool. And if you guys think it's just as cool as we do, why don't you tell a friend about us, tell a family member, maybe just spread the word, you know, be pretty cool. Another way you can spread the word about us is on Twitter. You can find us with the username @TIN_cast. And on our page, you can find all of our episodes. And if you retweet one of our episodes or use the #TINCAST to spread the word about us, you could also have a character named after you, which, in my opinion, is pretty awesome. We've done it for a few people already, and we could do it for you. We do have a Patreon, that's patreon.com/tincast. Not really asking you to give us money, but you want to go check it out. We might have some exclusive stuff on there at some point in the future. Obviously, we will have something up there eventually, but we may put something up there in the near future. Who knows? We also have an email, that's tincast13@gmail.com. If you wanted to contact us personally for any reason, you could do that. And if you like what you're hearing and you're listening on a service that lets you leave a rating or a review and subscribe, do so if you want to. And again, we really appreciate you guys out there listening to this. Whether you're new or you've been listening since episode one, we appreciate you. Seriously. Thank you guys. And we'll see you guys next week.
Let's try yours first.
Well, mine's already set to 3.4, 3.1.
You drew it. You drew it pointing to 13.4.
Yeah.
Okay. Nothing happens.
Okay.
I knock on it.
You knock on a piece of paper.
All right.
Knock on the wood.
I'm going to take the two dials that I've got, which are literally just like some buttons.
Okay.
Stuck on with some like marks, and I turn 1 to 13 and 1 to 4.
Mm-hmm.
And there's, like, a hole in it for where the speakers would be. I don't know. I take some, like, mesh wire, and I shit it in there, like, it's a speaker. And I'm like, Stolas, please, can you hear us at all?
You hear the faintest of faint crackles.
Okay. So.
Turn that bitch up.
Crank that knob.
I draw like a... Wait, I need an antenna. Maybe I should have like an antenna. Guys, help me find something for receiving.
Is there any metal around?
Is there a fishing pole anywhere?
Yeah, there's a fishing pole hung up against the wall.
I snap it in half and I give her the smaller half.
Okay. I like jam it in the wood.
Okay.
I try again. Hello?
What the fuck are you calling me through?
I built a radio!
This is... Oh my god, this is so bad.
Dude, it's either that or nothing. We just...
I want to be clear. This thing's made out of wood. There is no electronics in here.
So it looks like shit?
Yeah, it does.
Yes.
I'm no artist, but I tried my best.
Well, I hope you don't think I can get you out through
this. No, it's fine. We just wanted to somewhat get in contact and just... You know, figure out a plan.
Okay, hi.
Yeah, well, there's no radios here.
No, they're all gone. Of them
spontaneously blew up and...
Also, Isaacs refuses... First of all, we can't leave because we have no real radio that you can get us through. But secondly, Isaacs refuses to leave until we get him whatever's on that boat.
Boat?
What? There's a boat. There's a boat.
I can't really see much of what's going on.
That's okay. So we have a map now. He gave us a map. There is this, like, disease fog that if we venture into will turn us into gross fish people.
Oh, God. His denizens are fish people?
Yeah.
Like, or just
but
a
not
claw.
In a, like...
We only know... We already killed
not
one.
Not in a good way.
But, like...
Exactly.
Yeah, we're in, like, this resort town kind of thing. There's a big old boat that's...
Really, we need to get to a boat.
Yeah.
And we need to rob it.
Yeah, I guess so.
Of any and all valuables.
But we don't... But apparently all the radios in town blew up because...
Jesus! Sounds like the sponsor's trying to move quick here.
Yeah. So the only hope, honestly, is...
Wait, what do you mean?
Well, here's the thing. I think all that shit with Danica may have set off a red alarm elsewhere.
Oh, great. It's my fault again.
No, well, I mean, not just that, but you also did shut down a pretty successful portal. Like, they almost got through.
Right.
So, that whole closing thing may have put one or more into sort of overtime in terms of trying to kill off their host.
Okay, so I have a question.
So, wait, hold on.
I have a question.
Okay, go ahead.
But the sponsor needs to have at least one radio in the town, doesn't he? Because he has to have a way for them to get through and back?
No, it's not quite that simple, unfortunately. It's more like, think of it, this place that you're in right now and Danica's place, as like a halfway
mm-hmm.
between where I am and where you are.
Mm-hmm.
As the core grows more unstable mm-hmm. from the host's demise, it's sort of weakens that those barriers, and that's how they sort of poke on through.
Okay.
So wait, the whole point is to get a host in there.
Yes.
And then, like, connect the host to the core, more or less, and then kill the host so the core gets unstable so they can get through?
Yeah, exactly. Trying to
Guys,
take over the
just
world.
Just a reminder, never go into anywhere that he sends us and says, hey, you want to be a host?
Yeah, well, I don't ever host anything anyways, so it's okay.
Ooh, Ernest, you watch your own dimension?
No, fuck you, Solstice.
That was the right answer.
Okay, so. What, the question now is, what the fuck do we do? How are we going to get out?
Hey, is there any way you can give us some awesome explosives?
No! You're talking to me on a dinky wooden radio. I can't...
You act like this is not a miracle that we got this shit to work.
I mean, kind of. You got the fake radios in Danica's interrogation rooms to operate.
We didn't do anything with those. They were already there.
Yeah.
Like, we built.
We got Jimmy James's dinky-ass drone radio here. That didn't do shit.
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, well,
and
hey,
it's not even a 3D model.
Hey. I'm sorry. I was trying to do it quick.
Yeah, listen, we were experimenting.
We're not fucking aerospace engineers here.
What's space?
That means nothing to us.
All right,
okay.
All right. Give me the deets. Anything else you can tell me?
Okay, well, so everyone
So the citizens are fish people.
Yeah.
Everyone there is a fish person.
Yeah, the host has left. There's a big old There's this really large clearing square that's he's marked as weird. There's a boat in the middle of the body of water.
There's also a place called Meredith Lane.
That just sounds like a street name.
I don't know. Well, it's the only one labeled on this map. It sounds somewhat important. Wait, there are X's places.
Yeah. We haven't met him. He's just talking to us through speakers and stuff.
Oh, God, he's a paranoid one, too. That's great. Jimmy James, anything else on that map?
Well, the boat has an X.
Okay, anything else that's marked?
We know there's...
We got a house with a circle that's right next to the fog.
Why is it circled?
I don't know. Also, Meredith Lane, there's also a larger house that has a circle and an X.
So there's X. If X's mean treasure, we have no idea what circles mean.
I believe, hold on.
Why isn't there a...
Someone look outside. See if you can find out where we are.
I'm gonna look outside.
Check if you can see a street sign that says Meredith Lane.
Okay, yeah, you poke your head out the window. It is a, you're looking directly out at the sea across a road. And in the distance, you see a brilliant, gleaming ocean liner sitting out in the water.
Dandy, what do you see?
Okay, well, I see we're literally right next to the ocean. I can see the cruise ship. It's way out there. Looks really pretty. What else was I
supposed to say? Does there happen to be a road in between us and the ocean?
Yes. Yeah.
Cool. I know where we are.
Where are we?
We're at the circle and the X.
Okay.
So, if we were to swim straight, we would wind up at a boat. But if we were to walk out of this house towards the ocean and take a left and walk that way, we would get to the circle-y house.
You know what? You know why I think that's circled? I bet that's where he is.
You think he's just gonna lead you right there?
No, I wouldn't be surprised if that's where his other two guys are. No.
Wait, I thought they were all fish people.
No.
Okay, here's what happened.
Yep, we forgot.
Here's what happened. Yep. Two weeks ago, he was gonna go try and get into the boat that's in the middle of the water that has the treasure that he wants.
Mm-hmm.
He set a team. As soon as they were about to implement it, all the raiders exploded, and it killed one of his team members. And two of the other ones took off, and he hasn't seen them since.
He said they took off into the city.
Yeah, he hasn't seen them since.
But on this map, there is no city.
Why did they take off, though?
Probably because they got scared if a radio exploded, killing their friend.
But yeah, why that doesn't explain why they didn't come back.
Well, either they
It's a spooky town filled with fish monsters.
All right. We have two courses of action here. Well, technically three, but one of them I can almost assure will be death.
Okay. Yeah, no fog.
So one... We don't go in the fog. Swim to the boat.
Okay.
That one will probably die.
Well, we have to get out. Maybe we should find a boat.
Were you pointing at me?
We should find a boat and row out there.
Oh, all of us.
Okay.
Bet you anything, if we get on that boat, there's going to be something we're going to have to fight. Probably why they didn't.
Another fish man, lady.
All right. Well, maybe option number two, we can walk down the road to the circled house.
Do we go to the big circle house or the little circle house?
This circle house.
What about that one?
What one? Holy shit! Oh, I didn't even see that.
The big circle house.
All right. Well, then we have four options. We can combine them, two of them into one. So, I say my thought. We go to the big house. There's a big house behind us in the opposite direction of the ocean. We should head in that direction, and then we should keep going that way and go to the place labeled weird.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's
also how... Isaac's sucks at labeling maps.
Yeah.
Yeah, what a shit for brains.
Well, he is a janitor, not a map maker.
Cool. Has he ever looked at a map? Most of them have legends.
Yeah, right. Don't you need a map to get around the fucking building?
My God.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you need, like, fire escape ones. Yeah. Probably not.
Okay. Well, it sounds like you all have a good course of action.
Hey, Solstice? Stolas?
Stolas.
Yes, Jimmy James, what's up?
Any advice? Also, anything you could help us out with to get this host out of here? If I were your host, what would be the one thing you wouldn't want someone to say to me?
Or do.
Well, I don't think it's as simple as that. So, let me...
Wait! Sorry to cut you off, but what if the weird is the core?
Would you go label that weird, though?
Well, I would. That would be remember the big tower in Danica's place? Like, that giant weird tower?
Either weird or the ship.
Oh, yeah, it could be the ship. Fuck.
Maybe he just labeled it weird because all the weird shit goes on there, and like, you know.
Well, no. Wouldn't you want your host to connect with the core? So wouldn't you want your host to go to the core?
Do you need them to connect to the core?
No, it's sort of like they're powering it. It's not like they need to be there.
So yeah. You guys just use the people to just like...
Okay, you guys is sort of a generalization I'm not a big fan of.
Yeah, he hasn't actually done anything bad to us.
Quick question there. Do you have a dimension?
For the host?
Nope.
Can I, I don't know what kind of check. Can I be like 100% sure that he's not lying to me?
Yeah, you can make an intelligence check.
That's a 70.
Okay, sure. Well, yeah, you get the feeling he doesn't have any.
Okay.
Any other places. Okay, so Stoloff says, so let me just make sure I've gotten all of this straight here. Mm-hmm. So you have a stubborn host who wants a treasure that he believes is on the ship.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
He assembled a team.
Mm-hmm.
One of them died?
Yes. Yeah, when the radios exploded.
Okay. Did he give them a purpose? What did he say?
He wanted them to go infiltrate the ship.
Okay, but like, what did they do? Why them? Why these people?
Well, because they were experts at what they do. Yeah, one of them was a charismatic. One of them was an explosive expert.
Wait, hold on. Why would he need someone who's charismatic to get into a ship?
Fuck, I don't know.
Maybe he got a sweet talk, that sweet, sweet shit.
Open up door.
Anticipating resistance? Did anyone ask?
Oh, no, sorry, we were a little confused. Yeah, and no, I was a little bit freaking out that I couldn't talk to
our... Yeah, he was kind of rude.
We should probably, next time he comes around, we should probably ask him.
Okay, so...
He made it fairly clear that he never wanted to talk to us again.
Well, if he could, he has to. We have to get him out of here.
Let me just keep following the train of thought here.
Mm-hmm.
So, two of those members are still alive, and one of them is an explosives expert?
As far as we know, he's still alive.
The charismatic one died.
So, none of you are good with explosions, right?
No,
I'm good at stabbing.
I'm good with a whip.
Okay, yeah. It sounds like you kind of need to get into that chip if you're going to get him out of here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it kind of sounds like you're going to need some help to get into the ship.
Well, I was hoping, so long as they're not fish people now.
All right, if they're fish people, you're fucked.
Yeah.
But if they might still be alive...
He hasn't seen them in 2 weeks.
Well, I mean, if they're dead, fuck, guess you guys gotta heist the ship.
You know where I bet they would be?
Where?
Either in the big house or at Weird. Probably at Weird.
Well, let's figure out the big house first, and then, since it's just kind of on the way, and then we can hit Weird afterwards. And then if neither of those pan out, we can take the back road through the forest, and then cut through the backyard down here and get into the house next to Fog.
All right, well, let's head
to Big House.
You know what's also sucks? This asshole didn't label north, south, east, and west.
No. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. And I lower my voice at this point because we don't know if he's listening or not. He just stopped answering. We don't know if he actually left. I'm just going to lower my voice and be like, okay. Okay, I'm going to take apart the radio because I don't want him to come in and like smash it just in case... You know what? We don't really know anything about him. Maybe he's the one who got rid of the radios. So I'm going to very carefully take this apart so that if we really need to, we can put it back together and try and get in contact with you again, okay?
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. I'm going to go now.
Okay. Thanks for your help, my dude.
Yeah, you betcha.
You did so much. You were so useful.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye. Okay.
I pull the antenna out.
All right. Yeah, the static quickly cuts and...
I can't believe that worked.
You all now have a new plan and a new mission.
Should we bring the radio with us?
The pieces?
I would assume so, yeah. I mean...
We know that all these together will make a radio that works.
Okay.
Yeah, you can all carry the various pieces.
Do we have, like, backpacks? Is that, like, a thing?
Well, no one's brought backpacks.
I have a leather satchel.
Yeah, I think Jimmy J is the only one who has
it. Put the little pieces of, like, the buttons and the stuff in there. We can take turns carrying the box.
So, welcome to the misery of fortune.
Ooh.
And that's where we will end the main things. However, there is a quick afterwards I would like to do quickly.
Is it Louisa? Louisa's gonna finally write her poops.
No. I hope not.
Marcus Appleton.
Oh God. Boy, we left him and he was
pulled back into the community center.
Oh no.
In the back of the used Buick is an enormous radio.
Oh Jesus.
Why did they go to the little ones?
This guy's not the brightest.
Oh my boy.
After a confused talk with reception,
Kermit.
He sort of flips off the receptionist.
That's our boy.
Carries the radio into a random room, places it down, looks around, and is like, "Ah, Marcus, you really got yourself into a doozy this time." And as he talks, he leans against the radio.
No.
Please don't tell me.
A small
no, no.
Static
no,
no. begins emanating from it.